Me, I'll turn up again. So goddamn patron, you kill me. Got a bunch of songs up for y'all. Coming soon, maybe I've already, who knows, man, this time. Point blank period. Check out them patrons, man. Asian and Virgo in the public, you'll actually in the private because they patrons dance.
Offering, he had no regard. So Cain was very angry and his countenance fell. The Lord said to Cain, "Why are you angry? And why has your countenance fallen? If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin is lurking at your door. Its desire is for you, but you must master it." Cain said to his brother, "Let us go out to the field." And when they were in the field, Cain rose up against his brother Abel and killed him. Then the Lord said to Cain, "Where is your brother Abel?" He said, "I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper?" Word of God for the people of God. I want to deal with the thought just for a little while on this morning, when family matters go wrong. When family matters go wrong. I'm ready for that slide. So continuing from, of course, last month, and of course now moving into this month. Last month, our thematic thrust was I Am. And for the month of August, our thematic thrust is We Are. Taken from the African concept of village and Mbutu, I am because we are, and because we are, I am. And so we talked about that on Wednesday, and then of course we followed up with some of that at 8 o'clock this morning as we talked about the significance and value of relationships. relationships. Last month, we were dealing with doing self-reflection, self-inventory, and self-examination. That becomes important because if I see myself as valued, if I see myself as forgiven, if I see myself as loved, if I see myself as light, and if I see myself as salt, if I claim my divine identity, it also allows me to see others in the same way in which God sees me. I can see somebody else's light because I see myself as such. I can see somebody else as valued because I value me because God values me. So we spent, of course, July talking about, as Pastor Haynes said, becoming your own best friend instead of your own worst enemy, right? Making sure that we have some thoroughgoing understanding of who we are, one, so we can affirm who we are, so we can challenge ourselves to be more, while at the same time, so we can celebrate who we are and who God is making us into. So we dealt with that in July. And so on Wednesday, we talked about this notion of we are, understanding that as I understand who I am, my understanding is also connected to community. If I'm in a community that affirms me, that values me, that loves me, I in turn then share that within the community because I understand I'm nothing without the community, and I understand that the community needs me to be my better and best self for the community to thrive, for the community to grow, and for the community to flourish. So we talked about how relationships are what? Indicators of divine presence, how God puts us in
people's way.
When in fact we know that relationships are together by God with somebody else who will pray for us, somebody else who will cover us, somebody else who wants to see us grow into the crown that's above our head. You know what I'm talking about, indicators of divine presence. But we also talked about how relationships serve as means that hold us accountable. Relationships are important. Why? Because they hold us accountable to self. You got to have people around you that hold you accountable to be great. You said you possess the ability to be great. You got to have people around you that hold you accountable to be great. But also people that hold you accountable to God, what God said to you. Sometimes you got to have folks around you that remind you what you said God said to you. Let me say that one more time. Sometimes you got to have folks around you.
Stop the show. That's what I've been telling you. That's what I was talking about. Anyway, let's keep going.
Remind you what you said God said to you, what God has showed you in a dream, and what God has ultimately revealed unto you. You got to have folks that keep you accountable to God. And also, you got to have folks that keep you accountable to the goal, to the vision, and to the mission you have.
You said
you was going back to school. You said you were going to start a business. You said you were going to try to drop a couple over the summer.
You're going
to
be one man your whole life.
You're going to fast more. You got to have people that remind you of what you said you want for you.
Yep, you said you want to be one man your whole life. Damn it.
Every now and again, you get tired, you get frustrated, you get depressed, you get despondent, just trying to live, just trying to thrive, just trying to stay alive. You got to have folks around you who hold you accountable to be your best you. So not only did we talk about how relationships are indicators of divine presence, not only did we talk about how relationships are a means that hold you accountable, we also talked about how relationships serve as incubators. Well, wait, this is a freshman, this is falling.
I'm going to come up and say relationships serve as incubators